But it was pretty awesome to know that our footage of this ant can be used to start the conversation as to what this mystery ant is, if it's native, and if it's a brand new ant discovery that we the AC family made together. I will send this video to an ant taxonomist friend of mine who studies, identifies, curates, and gives names to new ant species all the time for antweb.org in my country, and ask him for his expert opinion on what he thinks this ant is. If it's worth investigating, at least we know they're living in Antopia, and I can take him and his team of taxonomists to our yard if they would like to hunt down and inspect our mystery ant in question further. Until our next eye-opening visit to Antopia, let's cross our fingers, guys, and hope for Murano plus AC Familius becoming a real species. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the AC family. Enjoy! Last week's video, where I proposed we'd made a new ant discovery, was a little controversial within the ant community online. The video solicited loads of mixed reactions. Some really excited about the prospect of being part of a breakthrough scientific ant discovery, and others on the other end, calling it fake and outright clickbait. This mixed reaction is totally expected, particularly the latter reaction, as skepticism is an important and necessary part of science, which is why research publications are peer-reviewed and open to the scientific community to check and verify. Otherwise, we'd just be believing everything we see and read on the internet, and sharing fake news, which is also not a good thing. But AC family, have I got some really cool news to share with you all! This week, I heard back from my myrmecologist friend and taxonomist for antweb.org, the global catalogue tracking all the ant species humans have ever discovered in the world, about the mystery ant we filmed in last week's episode. And turns out, he has confirmed that we AC family have indeed officially made a breakthrough scientific ant discovery. I repeat, we've all officially made scientific ant history. Keep on watching until the end, because I'll be going over everything my myrmecologist friend said about this gorgeous mystery ant we spotted in my yard. I asked him some questions about what our next step is now that we've made the discovery, why all of this is important to science, and how rare it is to make novel ant discoveries like ours in the world of myrmecology. But before all that, guys, there's one important thing I had to do first. I had to head back to Antopia, because I wanted to locate our mystery ant's nest. Welcome everyone to Antopia, this 3,000 square meter plot of land on which we are currently building our AC ant house, the custom home I'm building to house the various pet ant colonies and exotic beasts featured on this channel. As you saw in last week's episode, the second floor is now complete and they're working on the roof deck. I can't wait for us to move in later this year and start a new chapter on this channel in our new antiverse. So again, guys, don't forget to subscribe to be part of this new adventure. But one of the cool new things I've realized over the past few months is that the yard of our ant house is actually an amazing universe of wildlife on its own, full of neat hidden secrets that we gradually uncover more and more with every expedition through its soils. Our new ant discovery being such a prime example of this unexplored wilderness. Antopia's biological profile of living creatures and plants is so diverse and mind-blowing, I've given the yard a name, Antopia. Antopia's lush territory is full of thick, flourishing vegetation, animals, various insects, and of course, tons and tons of ants that interact with every life form in the area. Now, if you've been following the Antopia series on this channel, you already know how epic things get on a micro scale. In fact, there's nothing micro at all about the epic ant drama happening in the grass. And among the various armies of ants devouring monitor lizards, frogs, and termites, we also discovered a great war of the ants that is happening right under our noses in the great lands of Antopia. Now, this great war of the ants is important, which you'll see in a sec, as it pertains to our mystery ant we discovered last week. To recap real quickly for those of you who are new, before we finally delve into the details of our ant discovery, the Great Antopian War is between two major teams of ants. Team native ants, i.e. the ants who've been living in these lands for millions of years, listed here, and Team Invasive Ants, the ants who've been introduced to these lands via human activities, listed here, whose sole aim is to conquer Antopia and kill, displace, and outcompete Team Native Ants. We here at the channel don't particularly want these invasive ants around, because invasive ant species are completely volatile and can completely disrupt and ruin an ecosystem. So to help support all creatures living in Antopia, it's been my mission to help support Team Native Ants to win this great Antopian War of the Ants. And here, AC family, is where our new mystery ant comes in. I was feeding a native colony of marauder ants, who, by the way, need a name. So please leave your vote by hitting like in the pinned comments below for your favorite name for the marauder ants, as suggested by you guys in last week's episode. And I spotted a peculiar ant crawling around nearby. It was an ant I hadn't seen before, but I was spellbound by its utter beauty. I gave it some sweet jelly so I could have a closer look at it. The mystery ant had these cool long white hairs I'd never seen before on an ant, and had only seen on these ant-like wingless wasps called velvet wasps. But this was no velvet wasp. It had these beautiful spines on its thorax that kind of resembled an ant cape and two cute beady eyes on its neatly shaped head. So I allowed the ant to mosey along on its way after filming it and posted its photo in some ant forums online, and it was tentatively identified as the species Melanoplus bicolor. But when I checked antweb.org to see if Melanoplus bicolor was native to my country or if it was invasive, because if it was invasive, that would not be good news. To my surprise, Melanoplus bicolor was not listed as a species documented in my country. And so this meant one of three things. First possibility, this was in fact Melanoplus bicolor, and we were the first to discover that they actually existed in my country and were native. Two, this ant was in fact Melanoplus bicolor, and we were the first to discover that they actually existed in my country and were invasive. Or three, this ant was not in fact Melanoplus bicolor, but a brand new undocumented species of ant that looked close to Melanoplus bicolor. So after the video was published and the uproar of comments elicited a huge discussion online about the identity of this mystery ant, I sent the episode to the one man I knew who could tell us once and for all the truth about our mystery ant in last week's video. Dr. David General, top ant biologist, taxonomist, and affiliate curator of antweb.org and other ant identification websites specializing in studying ants within my country. I emailed him and wrote, "Dear Dr. General, I and all my subscribers are curious to know whether an ant we filmed this week may be a new ant species, a new geographic sighting of Melanoplus bicolor, or something else. The said ant is filmed in this video." I linked the episode and I couldn't believe what he wrote back. "Hello, AntsCanada. Good to hear from you after such a long time. I thoroughly enjoyed your video of the ants of Antopia, and seeing my friends Brian Fisher, Corey Moreau, and Benjamin Blanchard in your video was sweet as well. The ant in question is indeed Melanoplus bicolor, a new distributional record of the species, and a new species record. Congratulations on your great find! Now you can begin to understand the enduring motivation of taxonomic work. It's the high of discovering something new, be it a new record or a new species." Awesome! So he felt it wasn't a new species, but it was a new sighting of this ant in my country. He then requested I send him some specimens to officially verify that these were indeed Melanoplus bicolor, which made me wonder the following question. "Hi, Dr. General. Great news about the Melanoplus bicolor being reported in this country for the first time. Our subscribers of the channel, the AC family, will be thrilled with this news. But now I'm also wondering, what are the chances that upon examining the ant specimens we're sending you, that this ant actually turns out to be an undiscovered ant species and just closely resembles M. bicolor? In other words, is it at all possible that this is an undiscovered ant species? Or are you 100% certain it is Melanoplus bicolor based on the video?" And his response to me was surprising. Your ant is very close to Muranoplus bicolor, but it may still be a surprise. I'm reminded of the time co-myrmecologist Gary Alpert and I dismissed an ant from Mount Isorog as simply Tapenoma melanocephalum, a ghost ant, a cosmopolitan pest ant. Upon closer examination under the microscope, we found it to belong to an entirely different subfamily. The mimicry fooled two ant taxonomists. The ant turned out to be an undescribed species of Paraparatrachina or Nylandaria. And so guys, there you have it. It was still possible that our ant was in fact a new species, and Dr. General needed to have a look at specimens to review under the microscope to identify. So I went back to Antopia, searched high and low for the mystery ant's nest, found their nest, placed three workers into test tubes, and sent it to Dr. General's laboratory for examination. I'm happy to report that at the moment of upload of this video, Dr. David General and his team are examining the specimens right now, as you guys are watching, to verify the exact species of our mystery ant, and to let us know if this is indeed Muranoplus bicolor, or a brand new, undiscovered species. I'll let you guys know exactly what their findings are as soon as I hear back from their team of myrmecologists. And to also let you know where they publicly publish this new ant discovery we all found in last week's episode. Can you imagine that we all contributed to the growing knowledge of ant science and were part of ant history? High five, AC family, and a great job to us. I continued to ask Dr. General about why knowing the geographical distribution of ants is important to science and what our particular discovery tells us, as well as how common it is to make such discoveries in myrmecology, be the discoverers actual scientists or amateur non-scientist ant lovers like us. To which he said that we could derive useful information from knowing the geographical distribution of ant species. For instance, when an ant species suddenly shows up in a place far from its known native range, then we humans can assume that it was introduced and is invasive. However, when an ant is distributed among neighboring countries, then we may assume that the ant is simply native, which is possibly the case with our mystery ant we discovered if it is Muranoplus bicolor, because Muranoplus bicolor does exist in other surrounding countries within the region of the world in which I live. But again, we won't be able to tell until we get a full confirmation as to the species ID of the specimens Dr. General and his team are now examining. And guys, get this! Dr. General also mentioned that the chances of discovering new ant species in my country are very high, maybe 40 to 50%. Can you imagine that? Now, prior to our epic ant sighting last week, there were apparently 554 ant species known to exist in the country. And so our ant here has officially become ant species number 555 on the total number of ant species ever documented in the country. What a cool number, right guys? Now the Harvard guys, as Dr. General calls them, estimated that there may be as many as 1,000 ant species in the country. So, there are an estimated 445 ant species still to be found. Or, 445 divided by 1,000, equaling a 44.5% chance of finding a new ant species. That is an incredible number. He also went on to explain that the chances are improved when searching for poorly studied nocturnal ant species, which have been harder for biologists to spot and study. Time for us to get a blacklight and use it in Antopia, AC family. Overall, it was extremely exciting to be part of this scientific ant breakthrough. And it was also awesome to know that ordinary curious ant lovers like you and I can make valuable contributions to science. And to think, if we keep looking and exploring Antopia, our very backyard, we have a 45 to 50% chance of discovering a new ant species. This is crazy, and I believe this to be the start of a new personal mission of mine for this channel. Mark my words, AC family, if this ant that we filmed last week turns out to be Muranoplus bicolor, aside from the epicness of putting it on the global scientific ant map, I declare that one of these days, we will stumble upon a brand new ant species. This, I promise you, and I will continue to send any cool, suspect ant specimens we find in Antopia to Dr. General and his team, so we could one day hopefully name a species of ant AC Familius, after all of us, AC family. But meanwhile, now that the samples were being examined by the taxonomic pros, it was now time for us to have a closer look at our mystery ants here. I had so many questions like, what were they like? What did they eat? Were they friendly or aggressive? Outgoing or shy? And how could we find a queen so we could try keeping these ants we made ant history with? I went back to the nest and went in with my lens. AC family, did you enjoy today's episode? Can you imagine that we made an ant discovery? And let's not forget that we may have even discovered a new ant species. I'll be sure to let you guys know what Dr. General and his team find out. So, if you haven't yet, do smash that subscribe button and bell icon now and hit all so you get notified at every upload. Also, don't forget to hit the like button every single time, including now. It would really mean a lot to me, guys. Thank you. AC in our colony, I have left a hidden cookie for you here. If you would like to watch random sneak peek scenes of our unidentified mystery ant at their actual ant nest from our next episode, go check them out. And guys, be sure to visit AntsCanada.com for all your ant keeping and collecting gear shipped to you in a special package from our ant-loving facility in the USA. So you can get the most out of your ant keeping experience. We ship worldwide and also offer full email support if you need our help. We also have a helpful forum and ant colony trading marketplace on the site. Visit AntsCanada.com today. And now it's time for the AC question of the week. Last week we asked, what is your favorite feature of the new mystery ant in today's episode? Congratulations to Birth of Art, who answered, my favorite features are her chest, which has spikes, and how cute she is. Congratulations, Birth of Art, you just won a free ultimate ant keeping handbook from our shop. In this week's AC question of the week, we ask, what would you name our mystery ant if it turns out to be an undiscovered species? Leave your answer in the comment section, and you could also win a free ultimate ant keeping handbook from our shop. Hope you can subscribe to the channel as we upload every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help us keep making more. It's ant love forever.